Professional wrestling. It is without a doubt the greatest entertainment spectacle in the world. Nothing, and I mean nothing, has wrestling's influence. Nothing garners the same television viewership as wrestling, with the exception of news broadcasts, and nothing matches ticket sales to events. Nothing. Not football, not basketball, not baseball, nothing. Keep that in mind, as this is not just true in the United States, but also in the land of the rising sun, Japan. Japanese wrestling, or pro-wrestling, is awesome, giving us some of the greatest wrestling moments in history, as well as some of the greatest wrestling personalities of all time. So, with that in mind, I'm Walt, the most gangster nerd on YouTube, and these are 10 of the greatest Japanese wrestlers of all time. Hiroshi Tanahashi. This man is the definition of domination. Hiroshi Tanahashi is the only man to hold the IWGP Heavyweight Championship 8 times and has had it the longest with well over 1,300 days as the champion. Tanahashi has been New Japan's main man for almost a decade now, holding the IWGP Heavyweight title, the IWGP Intercontinental Championship, and the IWGP Tag Championships. Having insanely awesome matches with Shinsuke Nakamura, The Great Muta, and AJ Styles. Even as a rookie, he was already making waves after huge victories over greats such as Negro Cassis and even Scott Hall. In 2006, Tanahashi was to face IWGP Heavyweight Champion Brock Lesnar, but Brock Lesnar would be stripped of the title for failing to defend it. This is perhaps the greatest letdown in professional wrestling history, and oh, what WWE could have learned. Tanahashi would later win the tournament for the vacated title, and as time progressed, Hiroshi would also go on to win several other titles from around the world, having awesome runs in Mexico's CMLL as tag champion and universal champion, and even won the Tag Team Global Honor Championship in Pro Wrestling NOAH. Awesome. Giant Baba. Standing at an incredible 6'10" and tipping the scales at well over 300 pounds, Shohei Baba, better known as Giant Baba, started out under the legendary Ricky Dozan in the Japanese Pro Wrestling Alliance. Giant Baba was an attraction like no other, though perhaps not a technical master. His sheer strength and size, with his ability and personality, guaranteed he would be a success. In time, he would launch his own promotion, All Japan Pro Wrestling, and to add to that, he would become the very first Japanese wrestler to become NWA World Heavyweight Champion, holding it an impressive 3 times, and was the very first man to hold the Japanese Triple Crown. But along with all this, Baba was also an amazing booker and businessman. Unfortunately, in 1999, Giant Baba would pass away due to liver failure. But his promotion, All Japan, and his legacy will be around for a very long time to come. Satoru Sayama. You know you're a great performer when you can take a gimmick like Tiger Mask and make it a timeless international sensation. Satoru would debut in New Japan, though with little success. He would travel to Mexico wrestling for EMLL and would find incredible success, even becoming NWA Middleweight World Champion. In 1981, taking advantage of a popular anime at the time, New Japan would give Satoru the gimmick Tiger Mask. He would become an international sensation as a hard-hitting junior heavyweight. He would have several incredible matches against Black Tiger, Dynamite Kid, and Eddie Gilbert. As Tiger Mask, Satoru was incredible. He is the first and only man to hold both the NWA and WWF World Junior Heavyweight titles simultaneously. However, it would not be long after this, Satoru would grow disenfranchised with New Japan and would depart, vacating both titles after an infamous match with Akira Maeda, which seen Maeda shoot and land a low blow. Satoru Sayama would leave wrestling altogether, deciding to move into mixed martial arts instead as a trainer. Regardless, his legacy continues on as Tiger Mask 4, the fourth incarnation of Satoru's legendary character, is a popular wrestler today. Jushin Thunder Liger. Without a doubt, Japan's most recognizable light heavyweight. Jushin Thunder Liger has been a dominant force in Japanese wrestling for decades. Not many wrestlers can claim to be one of the greatest wrestling gimmicks, greatest high flyers, greatest technical wrestlers, greatest innovators, but Jushin Thunder Liger can. Interestingly enough, Liger, like others on this list, trained in Mexico, but also trained under Stu Hart in the legendary Dungeon. returning to New Japan and debuting as Jushin Liger before changing it to Jushin Thunder Liger, his star would skyrocket, proving to be a master and innovator, inventing the shooting star press and the running Liger bomb, and would dominate both junior and light heavyweight divisions. To add to that, he is one of only five wrestlers to hold the J Crown in Japan, consisting of eight other world titles, as well as the only 11-time IWGP Junior Heavyweight Champion. Incredible. The Ultimo Dragon. Calling the Ultimo Dragon one of the greatest Japanese wrestlers of all time is actually a disservice, as this man is without a doubt one of the greatest wrestlers in the world, as well as one of the greatest of all time. Mastering techniques from all over the world, whether it be the hard-hitting strong style in Japan, the high-flying, high-risk luchador style from Mexico, or the finely tuned technical wrestling popular in the US and Great Britain, the Ultimo Dragon can do them all and do them with such precision and excellence it boggles the mind. To add to that, he is one of the most decorated wrestlers of all time, the only wrestler in history to hold 10 championship titles simultaneously, those being all 8 titles of the J Crown in Japan, as well as the WCW Television Championship and the NWA Middleweight World Championship. He would hold and defend all 10 titles for over a year, taking him all over the planet. The Ultimo Dragon would, of course, make an attempt to wrestle in WWE, but unfortunately, WWE had no clue how to use the icon that was the Ultimo Dragon. And after only a year, Ultimo Dragon wanted a release from WWE so he could return to Japan, where they actually knew how to book wrestling. Yes, I said it. Antonio Inoki. Antonio Inoki is perhaps the greatest Japanese wrestler of all time and an absolute legend. Starting out in the Japanese Wrestling Alliance as a student of Ricky Dozan, Inoki would rise through the ranks, even tagging with the legendary Giant Baba, becoming NWA International Tag Team Champions a few times. Though over the years, Inoki would grow tired of the JWA, and after being released, he would start New Japan Pro Wrestling in 1972. Being an innovator, Inoki would combine vicious strikes and old-style catch wrestling, calling it strong style. Ever wonder where that came from? Now you know. He would put his organization on the map in 1976 when he famously fought Muhammad Ali, with the match ending in a draw. After this, New Japan was rocking and rolling, and Inoki cemented his reputation as both a professional wrestler and a businessman. Inoki would push New Japan to become the top Japanese promotion and would also set up international relationships all over the world, starting with the NWA and evolving with time to work with the WWE and later Ring of Honor in the United States, CMLL in Mexico, and even Revolution Pro Wrestling in Great Britain. Inoki would also take cues from other promoters, seeing how events like WrestleMania were a license to print money. He would create Wrestle Kingdom, a supercard event taking place on January 4th every year at the Tokyo Dome. It is a Japanese spectacle like no other. Also, in an attempt at goodwill, the Japanese and North Korean governments would come together and allow Antonio to promote the Collision in Korea in Pyongyang, a two-day event which featured the main event Antonio Inoki vs. Ric Flair. This would be the largest wrestling event in history with 190,000 in attendance. But even better than that, Inoki is also a member of the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame, the WCW Hall of Fame, the WWE Hall of Fame, and the Wrestling Observer Hall of Fame. Few can claim such an accomplishment. Antonio would also move forward and into politics, first being elected to Japan's House of Counselors in 1989 and serving until 1995, showing the entire world what a badass he really was as he went to Iraq alone and negotiated the release of Japanese prisoners and even promoted an event there. That's right, he punked down Saddam Hussein. He would be re-elected in 2013, and every time North Korea seems to want to get out of line with Japan, guess who goes over there and straightens them out? Antonio Inoki. The man is epic. Mitsuharu Misawa. Starting out in 1981, Misawa would debut in All Japan briefly before traveling to Mexico's EMLL. There he would incorporate the luchador fast-paced high-flying style into his arsenal. Upon his return in 1984, he would become the second incarnation of Tiger Mask. He would remain a force in the junior heavyweight class, winning the NWA International Junior Heavyweight title, but in 1990, he would unmask and abandon the gimmick. He would steadily move up the ranks, defeating legends such as Terry Gordy and Jumbo Tsuruta. In 1992, he would defeat Stan Hansen for his first Triple Crown Heavyweight Championship and hold it for an incredible 2 years. He would, in time, hold the Triple Crown 5 times, becoming the definitive face of All Japan's promotion and even becoming president of All Japan Pro Wrestling. However, after the passing of Giant Baba, the owner and promoter of All Japan, he would be ousted from this position and leave All Japan to form his own promotion, Pro Wrestling Noah. This is a major moment in Japanese wrestling history, as 23 other wrestlers all resigned from All Japan at the same time and all started with Pro Wrestling Noah. Misawa only got better as time went on. He would hold the Global Honor Crown Heavyweight Championship 3 times, as well as various tag team championships. Mitsuhiro Misawa would pass away, unfortunately, in 2009, with his family choosing not to have the details of his death released to the public. This man's legacy speaks for itself, as various promotions from all over the world observed his passing, so very few have accomplished this level of respect in the industry. Kenta Kobashi. Few wrestlers have had a career as awesome. This man is considered by many as the greatest wrestler of all time. Not one of the greatest, not the greatest Japanese wrestler, the greatest wrestler of all time. Kenta Kobashi would debut in All Japan in 1988, and by 1989, he was a star, dominating the tag team scene with several tag team championships with different partners. 1996 would see him win his first Triple Crown heavyweight title, which he would go on to win 2 more times. The turn of the millennium seen Kobashi, along with a bunch of other All Japan wrestlers, leave All Japan for Pro Wrestling Noah. Here, he would further his career, winning the Global Honored Crown heavyweight title and holding it for over 2 years. The longest title reign to date for that title. To date, he has wrestled in 23 separate Wrestling Observer 5-star matches and has had 6 Match of the Year awards with victories in all 6 of those matches. In 2005, he would travel to the U.S. for a dream match against Samoa Joe, the 2005 Match of the Year, in which he would emerge victorious. Something else to keep in mind about Kobashi is he is an innovator like no other. Being one of the greatest technical wrestlers of all time, he has invented some of the greatest wrestling moves ever, such as the Orange Crush Bomb, which looks utterly devastating, and of course, his apocalyptic Burning Hammer. Kaiji Muto. Perhaps better known as the Great Muta here in the United States, Kaiji would start out in 1984. Within 3 years, he would become an IWGP champ. Debuting on WCW Saturday Night in 1989 as the Great Muto, the son of Great Kabuki, legendary announcer Jim Ross would mispronounce his name as Great Muta, and thus the legend was born. Muto is a longtime favorite in the United States, having some of the greatest matches of the early 90s, against other legends such as Lex Luger, Sting, and Ric Flair. Participating in 4 consecutive Starcades, all while wrestling in New Japan and maintaining himself as a force there. In 1992 Starcade, he would defeat Barry Windham in the Battle Bowl to become NWA Heavyweight Champion, and later, defeating Masahiro Chono in Tokyo, Japan, for the IWGP Heavyweight Championship. He would become the first of only 2 men to ever accomplish this feat. He would make sporadic appearances in WCW all the way up until 1995, but his best stuff was happening in Japan, especially during the NWO invasion of New Japan. Kaiji Muto always managed to keep the fans guessing. At first, he was a die-hard New Japan loyalist, wrestling as Kaiji Muto, while also wrestling for the NWO as Muta, before completely aligning himself with the NWO. It's truly awesome and something you need to see to believe. As time would progress, he would also wrestle for All Japan, and along with winning the IWGP Heavyweight title 4 times, he would hold the Triple Crown Championship in All Japan for 3 times. He would resign as president in 2011 before starting his own promotion, Wrestle One, in 2013, where he has remained. Ricky Dozan. This may come as a surprise, but the greatest Japanese wrestler of all time, the father of modern-day Pooruusu, the owner of the first Japanese wrestling promotion, Rikki Dozan, was in fact not Japanese, but Korean. But don't worry, he didn't let that get in his way. Starting out his career as a sumo wrestler, he would transition to pro wrestling in 1951. Now this was post-World War II Japan, and pro wrestling was a very new thing. Rikki Dozan couldn't have picked a better time. He would defeat several American wrestlers, boosting his popularity, becoming something of a national hero all over Japan. He would found the Japanese Pro Wrestling Alliance, or JWA, in 1953. The very first Japanese wrestling promotion, launching with his feud against Masahiko Kamira, a judo black belt. As time progressed, he would travel to America, boosting his reputation internationally, wrestling for NWA Hawaii and the NWA Pacific Coast, holding titles in each as well as in Japan. He would take his game to the next level in 1958 when he defeated Lou Thesz for the NWA International Heavyweight title, setting a Japanese television viewing record. He would later shatter that same record in 63 when he faced the Destroyer. Unfortunately, Rikki Dozan would pass away in 1963, leaving a legacy that remains intact to this very day. It was him who trained both Antonio Inoki and Shohei Baba. Without Rikki Dozan, there is no All Japan or New Japan. Japanese wrestling would without a doubt look completely different without his immortal influence. And that is the list. Think I missed something or know something better? Let me know all about it in the comments. I'm Walt, the most gangster nerd on YouTube, and I'll be seeing you soon enough.